Hallelujah. 50. Psalm 50, verse 4. We are talking about supernatural harvest by the power of thanksgiving. Supernatural harvest by the power of thanksgiving. Thanksgivings bring so many things in our life. Hallelujah. God is so simple. Most of us, we complicate things. The way of God are simple. I say again, the ways of God are simple. But us as a human being, we want to complicate it. Thanksgiving is what we do as a believer. As a believer, you can't start a day before you thank God. You start your day with thanking God. With thanking God. You want to see blessing on the course of the day. Thank God when you wake up. You can't be too busy and not thanking God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You know, no matter how busy you can be, no matter if you wake up late, you will make sure before you leave your house, at least you brush your teeth. It's true? No matter how busy, no matter if you are late, you will make sure at least. Amen? Glory be to God. Amen. No matter which excuse that we can give, you can't give an excuse to give thanks. Thanksgiving is what believers do. Thanksgiving is what believers do. Psalm 50 verse 4. Psalm 50 verse 4. They can bless all. Amen. Psalm 50 verse 4. Psalm 100 verse 4. Psalm 50 verse 14, sorry.
Amen. Offer unto God thanksgiving and pay the vow unto the Most High.
Amen. Psalm 100 verse 4. And Psalm 103 verse 1 to 2. Psalm 100 verse 4. And Psalm 103 verse 1 to 2.
Enter into his gate with thanksgiving and into his court with praises. Be thankful unto him and bless his name.
Amen. Psalm 103.
Psalm 103 verse 1. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name.
Amen. Praise the Lord. And two.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not his all his benefits.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He will forgive all your sin and heal all your disease. He redeemed me from death. Hallelujah. He crowned me with love and tender mercy. We are serving a God that loves us so much. I can't tell you what that means. I say we are serving a God that loves us so much. It doesn't matter what you are facing in life. God wants you to acknowledge him in every aspect of your life. Acknowledge God when you wake up in the morning. Acknowledge God when you wake up in the morning. You know, when you start to acknowledge God by thanking him, your day will be full of blessing. Your day will be full of blessing. You know, in life, every day you are facing, you are meeting manipulators. People that are going around taking advantage of other people. But when you start your day by thanking God, God will fight the battle for you on the course of the week, on the course of the day. I come to declare over your life, any devil that is aroused against your life to frustrate your destiny and put confusion in the camp of the enemy in the name of Jesus. If you are the one, can I hear a ladder? Amen. Any witchcraft attack over your destiny, anything that the devil says against your life today, I declare it will never win you in the name of Jesus Christ. Start your day by thanking God. Start your day by thanking God. Hallelujah. Bible shows about something in Psalm, hallelujah, 50. Bible saying, hallelujah, offer to God thanksgivings. In another version, they say, hallelujah, sacrifice thanks offering to God. Hallelujah. Offer unto God thanksgivings. In other version, they say, make thanks, hallelujah, fullness, your sacrifice to God. Hallelujah. God wants you to start your day by thanking Him. There is so many blessings that is for us when we thank God for the day. Hallelujah. The area that you thank God, that area you never struggle. I say again, the area that you thank God, that area you never struggle. Number one, thank God for your life. Learn to thank God for your life. If you want God to fight the battle for you in every aspect, learn to thank God for your life. There are some people that they have some advantage in the past. They achieved so many things on earth. But Papa God didn't allow them to wake up today. So you and me, we have so many reasons to thank God. If I wake up this morning, it's not because I'm a good person. Because God allowed me to wake up this morning. I can't hear you, not the amen. God created you as a handsome, as a beautiful person, thanking Him. Learn to thank God for every good things that God is doing in your life. I can't hear you, not the amen. As you are thanking God, as you are thanking God, God will remove the struggle from your life. I can't hear you, not the amen. I remove every struggle from your life, from your business, from your career, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you are the one, can I hear another? Amen. I profess as the oracle of God, I declare, any devil that is sent against you, I declare that devil to be removed in the name of Jesus Christ. Learn to give praise. Learn to give thanks unto God. Thanking Him. Thanking Him. If you are a believer and you don't know how to thank God, you will backslide. Because the only one way for you to remain as a true believer is when you thank God. Because if you don't thank God, you find yourself backslide. You start to find yourself backslide. Because you start to envy other people. You start to envy other people. You want to become like somebody else. I refuse to be like somebody else. I can't hear your loud amen. I refuse to preach like somebody else. I refuse to do things like somebody else. I want to be me. And the reason for me to be me, I need to learn to thank God. I come to declare over your life as you hear the sound of my voice. This week, I see Papa God open many doors for you in the name of Jesus. If you are the one, can I hear another? Amen. I see Papa God decorate you in the name of Jesus. I see Papa God elevate you in the name of Jesus. I see Papa God connect you in the name of Jesus. I see Papa God make you rich in the name of Jesus. I see Papa God fight the battle for you in the name of Jesus. Learn to thank God. Thank God for your life. You want to win the battle of life. Start to thank God for your life. Appreciate, hallelujah, the grace that God gave to you. Great. That ability to communicate with other people, ability to talk, ability to speak and to reason. When you thank God for that, you will never find yourself in that hospital of the people that are losing their mind. I can't hear your ladder, amen. I come to declare over your life, you will never lose your mind for the rest of your life in the name of Jesus. It doesn't matter the witch and the wizard of your village. Any battle that they send to you, any spiritual bullet that they release over your life, I declare that bullet is going back to send in the name of Jesus. I declare that bullet is going back to send in the name of Jesus. You will never die before your time. You will never appear on the altar of your enemy. If you are the one, can I hear another amen? This November, December, I see confusion in the camp of your enemy. They will never succeed at all. I can't hear your another amen. Bible says, greater is the one that is in me than the one that is in the world. Don't elevate the devil. Don't elevate what the devil is doing. Elevate the name of God. God, I thank you for my life. This is the best time to be alive. I can't hear you, Lord, amen. We are seeing left and right the goodness of the Lord. I can't hear you, Lord, amen. We are seeing left and right the goodness of the Lord. They're talking about COVID-19 is airborne. They're talking about there are so many confusion. But we have our doctors, our nurse that are waking day. They are seeing those patients that they have COVID-19. But that they are coming home without COVID-19. That is the goodness of the Lord. I can't hear your ladder, amen. It's the goodness of the Lord. They start to do some study. They say that if there is somebody having COVID-19, that virus will remain in that place for some time. But God always protects. There is a reason that you can thank God. Friend, learn to thank God. Because when you are thanking God, God will fight the battle for you. When you are thanking God, God will fight the battle for you. You know what God will do? God will show the world like this one is mine. This human being is mine. I can't hear your ladder, amen. He will show the world, like, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Like Prince Will, is belong to me. When you are thanking God, God will call you by name, and that he will elevate you in the midst of your enemy. I come to declare over your life, this week, every struggle, any problem that you face in the past, I declare those problems will never crush you in the name of Jesus. I can't tell you that, amen. And I say, will never crush you in the name of Jesus. Learn to thank God. He won't take your time, but he will do more things in your life. He will do more things in your life. The more you are thanking God, the more God will protect you. The more you are thanking God, the more God will protect you. I will spend the rest of my life thanking God. I will spend the rest of my life glorifying the name of God. Learn to thank God. Number one, thank God for your past. Learn God, thank God for your past. Your past may be good. Your past may be ugly. But thank God for your past. You are who you are today. You are born again. You are a child of God. Because there are certain bad things happened in the past. Thank God for your past. The good, the bad, and the ugly. Thank God for that. I can tell you that, amen. Amen. Number two, thank God for your present. You may not be where you want to be. You may be in one bedroom with five people. Hallelujah. No privacy at all. But I thank God for that situation. Thank God for that situation. And don't even allow anybody to make you feel inferior. Thank God for that situation. You are in one bedroom with all your entire family, five children in one bedroom. Thank God for that situation. Thank God for that. The more you are thanking God, God will remove you from one bedroom to two bedrooms. The more you are thanking God, God will give you grace to buy your own house. Amen. The only one way for you to move from one level to another level is to appreciate what God is doing in your life. It may be small, but thanking him. It may be small, but thanking him. Hallelujah. Because if you can't thank God, your life is in danger. If you can't thank God, your life is in danger. If you can't thank God, you're going to sell your soul for money. I can't hear you. If you can't thank God, you're going to sell your soul for a car. Learn to thank God. I can't hear you. Say, I will thank the name of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Many people that they succeed today, maybe financially, if we are talking about financially, they went through difficult moments. They went through difficult moments. So you and me, we need to thank God for who we are, for the level that God gave to us. I don't want things, my redeemed live. Hallelujah. I don't want things, my redeemed live. I don't want things, God, you never allow the enemy to crush me. I can't tell you that, amen. When I pass through a difficult moment, I know God is by my side. I can't tell you that, amen. I know one thing, God is my light and my strength. Hallelujah. Bible says, who shall I be afraid? Psalm, hallelujah, 27, verse 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I be afraid? God is your light and is your salvation. The Lord is the strength of my life. Who shall I be afraid? Friend, learn to thank God. Your secret is not that connection that you have. Your secret of prosperity is not that connection. It's not that person that is favor you now in business. Your secret is God. Your secret of prosperity is not that job or that manager that is continuing to favor you. Your secret is God. Remember, Joseph enjoyed the house of Potiphar. But it took only a second for Potiphar to change his mind. The same person that was favored, hallelujah, Joseph, is that person that threw Joseph in prison. People, they can change. Their mood can change. They can reject you at any time, but the one thing that you need to do, if you put your trust in the Lord and that you thank God in every situation of your life, God will never abandon you. I can't tell you another amen. Another thing is when you are thanking God, God will remove every roadblock to your success. There is some roadblock. There is so many roadblocks. But when you are thanking God, God will remove roadblock. Sometimes you look special this season. We used to think about, praise the Lord, if they open the economy, as you open your shop, there'll be so many people. Until they allow your shop to be open, then you realize more clients is coming. They already say you can run your business, but are no clients. But that is take God's favor. Amen. For the client to come this season. Amen. I see that favor is coming to you. Amen. I can't hear your other amen. Amen. I see your amen is weak. I say, can I hear a loud amen? Hallelujah. Psalm 107, verse 1. Psalm 107, verse 1. Glory be to God. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. God is what? He's good. God is good at all times. Don't allow your situation to make you believe that God is not good. God is good at all times. He's good when I have job. He's good when I don't have job. He's good when I have money for the rent. He's good when I don't have money for the rent. God is good at all times. Sometimes God can allow bad things to happen to our life because he wants to teach us the heart of the people that are around us. Because when you have money, everybody, they are laughing with you. Until when you find yourself you don't have nothing, then you realize who stands for you. And at some time also, God can elevate you for you to know who is for you. When God bless you by surprise. Hallelujah. People that they know you, they are surprised. Oh, this person now is in this level. Financially, you will see from their eyes. You know when somebody is pretend, you will know. Body language is a powerful thing. Powerful tools. Body language, you can't hide. Why are you said, I'm not feeling okay? It's a lie. My breakthrough is already punished you. I can't hear your other amen. I come to declare over your life, every place that you go, your enemy, they will go down in the name of Jesus Christ. Though they are planning you for you to go down, they will go down at your place in the name of Jesus Christ. You go higher in the name of Jesus Christ. Confusion is far from your life. I can't hear your other amen. I said confusion is far from your life. Favor is with you when you are thanking God. When you are thanking God, God will open the door for you. Thanking God, he always opens the door for us. We want to see favor. We want to see increase. We want to see stability. We want to move from one level to another level. Let us, hallelujah, make our habits. Let it be our habit. Thanking God. If you can thank God, you will see supernatural. God bless you, sir. You will see supernatural happen in your life. Show me somebody always thank God. I will show you is a person of favor. Is a person of favor. Doors will be open for you. Doors will be open for you. Doors open for Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego because they have one attitude. Appreciating God.
Amen.
Appreciating God. You may be surrounded by your enemy, but I don't allow the attitude of your enemy to crush you. I can't tell you another amen. Don't allow their mood to crush you. There are some people that are negative in life. Everything, this will not work. This is in one way. But when you are thanking God, God will remove you from the people that are there to kill your dream. I come to declare over somebody that hear the sound of our voice. The blessing that your parents didn't enjoy, I see from today, you start to enjoy those blessings in the name of Shadrach. Hallelujah. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego in Babylon. Attitude of appreciating God. I know when they arrive to the front of the king, they say, oh, king, live forever. A person that thank God is a person that appreciates everything that God is doing. In the bad things, there is a good thing that is happening. In the bad things, there is a good thing that is happening. Number two, you need to thank God also for your future. God, I thank you for my future. You promised me. You know, people like us, I know who I am. I know my future. I don't want shortcuts. If it will take God for another 10 years for me to be in this level, I'm not stressed. As long as I'm in this level with God. I can't hear your ladder, amen. Because God can change your story in 1 second. God can make you a millionaire in 1 second. God can connect you and make you a person of influence in 1 second. Somebody like Moses, he said unto God, if you are not going with us, we won't go. Don't be in rush. When you are seeing people, they are moving forward. Don't try to envy them. You are serving a God that is in control. I can't hear your ladder, amen. I said, you are serving a God that is in control. As long as you are trusting God, as long as you are obeying God, as long as you are thanking God, and are doing the right things, working with your hand, God will open more doors for you. Start to thank God for your promise. There are so many things that God already promised you. You become this. You are a businessman. You'll be this. Your family will be this. Start to thank God for that promise. Start to thank God for that promise. You know, when you are thanking God, hallelujah, God will direct your step. For you to find yourself enjoying what is belong to you. I come to declare over your life, from today you declare like David. I was young, now I am old. I never see a righteous forsake. I declare God will never forsake you. I can't share your ladder, amen. God will never allow confusion to locate you. God will never allow you to die before your time. If you are the one, can I hear your ladder, amen. God will never allow your enemy to attack your blessing. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Friend, your future is brighter. I come to declare as an oracle of God, from today, every business that was not working, you start to work from today in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank God. Thanking God is a good thing. You can thank also God for the people that God put around you. Learn to thank God for the people that God put around you. Thank God. Hallelujah. Thank God for the people. Thank God for your family. Thank God for your family. Learn to thank God for your family. In the list of priority, God needs to be your priority. God needs to be the source of your life. Never allow anything to take the place of God. God is the source of your life. When you have money, connect to God. When you don't have money, connect to God. When you are waiting for your breakthrough, keep on connecting to God. Keep on thanking God. When things are tight, keep on thanking God. You know why the devil sometimes is trying to challenge your business, your career? Because the devil wants you to backslide. But your love for God needs to be above anything that you possess in this world. I communicate to somebody. I say, I communicate to somebody. God needs to be the source of your life. Number two, your family. Don't put your friend above your family. Don't put, there are some people, they put their friend above their wife. Why your amen is weak? There are some people, they put their friend above their wife. There are some wives, they put their friend above their husband. That friend of yours will leave you tomorrow. Small things, my friend. Small things. Even your husband said, can you leave that friend of yours? No. Your friend, he come from work. No food, no nothing, because you are busy with your friend. I pray for somebody that hear the sound of a voice. I declare by the blood of Jesus, as you value your family, as your family remains, hallelujah, your priority, no devil will crush your family in the name of Jesus. Even Bible say, a house that is united, it can't be denied. Hallelujah. If your house is strong, if you are united in the house, united in the house. God is our source. Number two, my family. I will do everything to keep my family. I will pray for my family. I will speak to my family. Hallelujah. I will support my family. God, give me money. Let them enjoy it. God bless you. Enjoy your money, number one, with your family. After you already pay your tithe, your offering, your prophetic, whatever things that you want to do for God, let your family enjoy your money. I can't hear your ladder. Let them enjoy it before your friends have to enjoy it. Let them enjoy it. Your life starts in your family, and then your life will end in your family. You are born there. Hallelujah. There is no guarantee that your friend will come to your funeral. But one thing is for sure, your family will be there. They will be part of the preparation and the burial and everything. So let your family enjoy you. Let them enjoy your presence. Let them enjoy your finance. Let them enjoy your wisdom. I can't hear your last amen. Amen. Let them enjoy your wisdom. Let your family be one. We have some place that are dividing family. Family is your number one priority on earth. Except God. God is a source. Your family is your priority. Bible says if you are not taking care of your family, you are worse than a pagan. You are worse than a pagan. So God wants us to put our family as a priority. Show me a family that is strong. It's a family that is united. It's a family that's united. It's a family that is united. You go to some place, they say your mother, she's a witch. Say, thank you very much, prophet. Can you deliver my mother? Because when I was small, I was drinking the milk for my mother. She didn't give me witchcraft. Now I am old. When I was small, my bones was too weak. She could eat me very well. She didn't. Now this age, she want to eat me? No way. Dividing family. There's a brother like that. Dividing family. Family is your priority. In every family, there is bad people. But it's my family. It's my blood. I can't hear your loud amen. When I was small, we used to have one of my cousins. We know she was a witch. She was a witch. No revelation. All of us were not born again. But we knew she was a witch. If she, they didn't even allow her to cook. Forget about that. Even to send her to the market to buy things, no way. But she was always number one in school. Always number one. All of us, we used to know she's a witch. So even like when they want to make food, they will make sure that she will have a portion. But very intelligent. But when it becomes for mathematics, I go to her. Teach me mathematics. Because she was very intelligent in mathematics. But in other things, for her to give you food, no way. I remember one day, praise the Lord, they give us some money to take the present of the bus. Glory be to God. We enter in the bus. She refused to pay. She said to us, like, this kid, they want to go to the bathroom. As we go outside, he said, kid, run! They're going to catch you. They'll catch you. All of us, we run. And we realize one thing, the money that they give to her, she didn't pay. For transport. You are too small. We are in creche. I'm sure like even those people, they just look at me, those kids. She did so many things, but that she was a family member. Don't allow. You are not scared of the witch because you are a child of God. I can't hear your ladder again. I say again, don't be scared of the witch. You are a child of the Most High God. Your amen is weak. I don't know why. I say your amen is too weak. I don't know why. Are you fasting this morning? Can I hear a louder amen? I say, can I hear a louder amen? We are not scared of the witch. We are not scared of the wizard. Greater is the one that is in me than the one that is in. If you are a witch, you are a witch for yourself. I belong to Jesus Christ. The love of God is at work in me. I can't hear your louder amen. The blood of Jesus Christ is in me. I am more than conquerors through Jesus Christ. I can't hear you loud, amen. But I don't allow anyone to destroy your family. Your family is your priority. Value your family. If you want God to bless you, value your family. Your family need to remain your priority. Hallelujah. I can't hear you loud, amen. Say, I will praise the Lord for my family in the name of Jesus. Thank God for your family. Thank God for your family. You want to see so many blessings in your life. Learn to thank God for your family. Thanksgivings. Always. Hallelujah. Thanksgivings bring so many blessings in our life. Because when we are thanking God, we are provoking God to do more in our life. You don't live, hallelujah, you can't conceive. You are seeing other people have their own children. Now you can put your hand on your stomach and then start to declare, God, I thank you for my baby girl. I thank you for my baby boy that is on the way. Father, I give you glory. So as you are thanking God in your house, before you know, boom, you are pregnant. Of course, if you are married, no pregnant of your boyfriend. I can't hear your ladder anymore. We need to make sure. Somebody's coming. Pastor, I can't conceive. Are you married? No. Thank you very much. Go first, Mary. Then we're going to come to the door. How you know you can't conceive? How you know? How you know? Don't twist the prayer point. There are some people that can use tricks. How you know? How you know you can't conceive? Go first in marriage. After you enter in marriage, then we'll talk. 1 year, then you say, Pastor, I can't conceive, I'm working. Where is your husband? Then let's pray. It's true? You can't say your business is not working and you don't have no business. Go start first a business. Pastor, my business is not working. What is your business? What is the business? Pastor, I don't know. Allow God. That's why thanksgiving will help you to think. Because when you are give thanks unto God, God will give you grace to reason. Jeremiah 29 verse 11. I know the thought that I have for you. God is a thinker. If God wants to change your level financially, he wants to change your level, God will give you some idea. You can't come for prayer for God to bless you in business and you don't have no idea for business. What are you going to do? Pastor, I don't know. Can you tell me what I will do? No, there are certain things prophet can't tell you. Amen? You need to have your choice first. Prophet, I come so that God can tell me which business I will do. You are wasting your time now. Amen? But when you pray, when you are thanking God, during the night, God will come to you. God will start to show you, can you do this? Can you do this? Can you do this? God will give you idea. Amen? Praise the Lord. I can't hear you, not amen. I said, I can't hear you, not amen. How many people they love these beautiful things? These beautiful things. How many people they love it? Your amen is work. I love it. It's shining. It's beautiful. Amen? My brother, can you stand? Can you stand? These two precious people. That is their work. They are doing these things. Amen? They are doing these things. Amen? They can do the animal, the head of the animal, and they're doing with these kind of things. Amen? When you are, you can see, praise the Lord. Glory be to God. So you want something like that, you know them. Don't come to me. Don't give me money. If you give me money, I'm going to eat it. I don't want that thing, so fast I eat my money. No, no. If you want it, don't come to me, daddy. Amen. So, it's very important. When you always give thanks unto God, God will show you your gifts. He will show you what you need to do in life. There are some small things that you know how to do it, but you are not value it. But when you are thanking God, you know what God is reviving you? He's reviving you, hallelujah, that attitude of appreciation. There are so many gifts inside of you, but you are looking, there are some people, you know how to cook. You know how to talk to people. There are some people, you don't know how to cook, but you know how to talk to people. You can sell anything. Anything. People, they'll buy it. Hallelujah. But you are just looking for a job. Up and down, looking for it. But when you start to thank God, God will say to you, relax. You know, I thank God for COVID-19. I thank God for the lockdown. Amen. Lockdown opened the eyes of many people. Amen. Some people, their eyes was America. If I go to America, Donald Trump is going to give you money. Big house. You're going to live in the project. You know project? You don't know project, go Google. Go Google, America, their project. People that are living in. When somebody is coming from project, his English is broken. Even those who are born in America. But the one thing that we know, praise the Lord, COVID-19 is false. COVID-19 is false. We discover one thing. Life is not those empty hope that we have. If I travel another country, I'll become the richest person. This country, they're wasting my time. Every country, there is poor people. One thing about America, France, and other places, they are showing only the good side. They are not showing the worst side. Why? Because they want you to believe like everything there is better. Until you enter there, then you realize you are in project. I will spend my life in the project. I refuse that. But one thing that I know, when you are thanking God, God will allow you, God will give you that heart to value the small one that you have. And the working heart will want the small one that you have to bring it to another level. Remember when you were in school, you start your class in creche. You are going to grade one. When they say, 1 + 1 = 2. You remember? Yes. They're screaming and you are screaming. When you go to grade one, the teacher, they need counseling up. 1 + 1 = 2. Again, 1 + 1. But we grow from that level to another level. Grade one, grade two, grade and university. And after that, we start our career. Life is step by step. Friend, don't allow anyone to deceive you. Don't allow anyone to deceive you like there is some country that is better. Your life will be better. Your life will be blessed when you have God.
Amen.
Because when you have God, God will open the window of heaven. When you have God, God will direct your step to a place where you will be celebrated. As you are putting your hand up, I bless your hands. I can't hear your other amen. I bless your hands. I bless your career. I bless everything that is belong to you. I declare, may God connect you. May God honor you. May God decorate you.
Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel,